يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ ولا تجهروا له بالقول كجهر بعضكم لبعض أن تحبط أعمالكم وأنتم لا تشعرون إن الذين يغضون أصواتهم عند رسول الله أولئك الذين امتحن الله قلوبهم للتقوى لهم مغفرة وأجر عظيم إن الذين ينادونك من وراء الحجرات أكثرهم لا يعقلون
O you who believe, do not venture ahead of, to Kadamu, derives, from Kadama, with the sense of, the fifth form, Takadama, that is to say, do not come forward with any, unwarranted, saying or deed, ahead of, God and His Messenger, the one communicating, the message, from Him, that is to say, without their permission, and fear God. Surely God is hearer, of your sayings, knower, of your deeds. This was revealed regarding the dispute between Abu Bakr and Umar, may God be pleased with them both, in the presence of the Prophet, s, over the appointment of Al-Aqra, b, Habis or Al-Qaqa, b, Mabad as commander, of his tribe.
وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ صَبَرُوا حَتَّى تَخْرُجَ إِلَيْهِمْ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَإٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا أَنْ تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ فَتُصْبِحُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلْتُمْ نَادِمِينَ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لَوْ يُطِيعُكُمْ فِي كَثِيرٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْرِ لَعَنِتُّمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانَ وَزَيَّنَهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْعِصْيَانَ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الرَّاشِدُونَ فَضْلًا مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَنِعْمَةً وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ حَكِيمٌ
The following was revealed regarding those who raised their voices in the presence of the Prophet, S.O. you who believe, do not raise your voices, when you, want to, speak, above the voice of the Prophet, when he is speaking, and do not shout words at him, when you, wish to, confide in him, as you shout to one another, but, speak, lower than that, out of reverence for him, lest your works should be invalidated without your being aware. That is to say, for fear of this, happening, as a result of the raising of voices and the shouting mentioned. The following was revealed regarding those who used to lower their voices in the presence of the Prophet, S, such as Abu Bakr, Umar and others, may God be pleased with, all of, them, truly those who lower their voices in the presence of God's Messenger, they are the ones whose hearts God has tested for God-fearing, that is to say, He has tested them, so that this, fear of God, may manifest itself in them. For them will be forgiveness and a great reward, paradise.
وَإِن طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ اقْتَتَلُوا فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا فَإِن بَغَتْ إِحْدَاهُمَا عَلَى الْأُخْرَى فَقَاتِلُوا الَّتِي تَبْغِي حَتَّى تَفِيءَ إِلَى أَمْرِ اللَّهِ فَإِن فَاءَتْ فاساءت فأصلحوا بينهما بالعدل وأقسطوا إن الله يحب المقسطين إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يسخر قوم من قوم لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكن خيرا منهن ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون.
The following was revealed regarding a group of people who came to see the Prophet S during the midday, resting, period while he was in his house, and called out to him, "Truly those who call you from behind the apartments, the private chambers of his womenfolk, Hujarat is the plural of Hujra, which is an area of ground on which stones are laid, Yujaru, Alehi, to form a wall or the like. And it happened that each one 605 of them called out, in that rough and crude Bedouin manner, from behind one of the apartments, as they did not know in which apartment he was, most of them do not understand, given the way in which they acted, your exalted status and the reverence that befits it. And had they been patient, anahum, they, has independent status, on account of inceptiveness, alternatively, it is said to govern an implied verb such as the bada, had, their patience, been maintained, until you came out to them, it would have been better for them, and God is forgiving, merciful, to those of them who repent.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا أيحب أحدكم أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه واتقوا الله إن الله تواب رحيم يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن الله عليم خبير.
The following was revealed regarding Al-Walid bin Aqba, whom the Prophet had sent to the Banu al-Mustalik in order to ascertain their loyalty to Islam. He already feared them on account of an old feud between him and them from the time of pagandom, before Islam, and so, upon seeing them come out to him, he returned and claimed that they had refused to give the voluntary alms and intended to kill him. And just as the Prophet, S, was making plans to raid them, they came to him to disavow what he, Al-Walid, had said about them, "O you who believe, if a reprobate should come to you with some tiding, some piece of information, verify it, ascertain his truthfulness from his mendacity," Fatabayanu, a variant reading has Fatathabadu, from Al-Thabit, "to ascertain, lest you injure a folk," and Tuzabu common, an object denoting reason, that is to say, for fear of this, happening, out of ignorance, by jahalatin is a circumstantial qualifier referring to the subject, of the verb, that is to say while you are ignorant, and then become remorseful of what you have perpetrated, erroneously against that folk. After they had returned to their homelands, the Prophet, S, sent Khalid, B, Al-Walid, to them, who observed only obedience and goodness in them and, later, inform the Prophet of this.
قالت الأعراب آمنا قل لم تؤمنوا ولكن قولوا أسلمنا ولما يدخل الإيمان في قلوبكم وإن تطيعوا الله ورسوله لا يلتكم من أعمالكم شيئا إن الله غفور رحيم إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون قل أتعلمون الله بدينكم والله يعلم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض والله بكل شيء عليم يمنون عليك أن أسلموا قل لا تمنوا علي إسلامكم بل الله يمن عليكم أن هداكم للإيمان إن كنتم صادقين إن الله يعلم غيب السماوات والأرض والله بصير بما تعملون
And know that the messenger of God is among you, so do not speak falsehood, for God will inform him of the real state of affairs. If he were to obey you in many matters, which you communicate contrary to reality, so that the necessary, evil, consequences ensue, you would surely be in trouble, you would earn in addition to that sin, the sin for the consequences that ensue, from your error. But God has endeared faith to you, adorning your hearts with it, and he has made odious to you disbelief and immorality in disobedience, an instance of suppletion with respect to import, as opposed to lexical form, for the one to whom faith has been endeared, and so forth, will naturally be dissimilar in character to the mentioned reprobate. Those, there is here a shift from the second to the third person address, they are the right-minded, the ones firmly established upon the way of their religion. That is, a favor from God, fadlan is a verbal noun, in the accusative because of the implied verbal action, that is, aftala, he gives a favor, and a grace, from him, and God is knower, of them, wise, in his bestowal of graces on them.